Go! Yeah. teams met in East Lansing, and Michigan State moves into first place with a 4-2 win over Lake Superior. Our Mark Wilson has all the highlights and story from Munn Arena.
The battle for first place wasn't much of a battle tonight. Jamie Stewart, after a benching last week, made some big saves, but MSU's defense didn't let Jamie see much tonight. On the other side, Mike Greenlee saw a Steve Beadle slapper go past him at 5:56, and MSU led one zip. 2.5 minutes later, it was Kip Miller on the power play and a 2-0 state lead. Lake Superior got on the board at 3:53 of the second period. Mark Vermette on the power play, his 19th goal of the season. MSU opened it up 5 minutes later. Bobby Reynolds on a pretty setup from Tom Tilley for the goal, and then Sean Hafey, an unassisted slapper to make it 4-1 after two periods.
It was painfully obvious to Lake Superior coach Frank Anzalone that the work Michigan State did in preparation for the U.S. Olympic team has carried over the past two weekends. It was 4-1 after two periods, and yet it could have easily have been 10-1.
Michigan State could have phoned in the third period as they ring up the 4-2 victory, MSU's eighth win in their last nine games.
I think your goal is the thing that kind of broke their back tonight.
Well, I don't know. I think any of the goals would have broken their back at that time. I'm just happy to have gotten it, I guess.
I thought we played hard and thought that we checked well, and we got the goaltending when we needed it, and we got the plays we needed, and that's what counts.
Tonight, MSU is back in first place by 1 point over the Lakers, with the series wrap-up coming tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock. At Munn Arena, I'm Mark Wilson for TV 10 Sports.
Okay, Mark, at Joe Louis Arena tonight, an incredible hockey game. The Red Wings 12, the Chicago Blackhawks nothing. Greg Stephan the shutout. The Red Wings have won 5 straight. The Blackhawks have lost 5 straight. 6 quick goals in the first period. Take a look. Chicago goalie Bob Mason was just absolutely shell-shocked early on. 24 seconds into the game, John Chabot to Tim Higgins. This bouncing puck goes into the net to make it 1-0. 13 seconds later, Steve Yzerman on the follow here. That makes it 2-0. Less than 1 minute later, here is Chabot once again scoring. That makes it 3-0. Just a couple of moments later, the Red Wings are on a power play. Joe Murphy, a nice move here. The ex-Michigan Stater, his 5th goal of the season, 4-0. A few minutes later, this is the prettiest goal of the year. Klima to Ashton, to Klima. There's a goal, 5-0, 13th for Klima. And then shorthanded, Brent Ashton gets his 10th, makes it 6-0. After all these goals were scored tonight, the Wings forward Johnny Chabot was asked about the onslaught.
Shots quite a bit. We're trying to hit the net more often than not. In the games, we get the good chances, but it seems like we're missing the net by those 2 or 3 inches, and we're trying to be too fine. Well, now Jacques just taking the goalies out of the net and saying, just hit the net, and if you miss the net, it's 10 push-ups. So went through an hour and a half of that one day, and we're just, you know, we're just trying to hit the net from here on in. If we can do that, I can see the last 3 or 4 games, we're starting to get some goals.
Are they ever getting some goals? And at the Silver Dome tonight, the Pistons burying the Boston Celtics, 128-105, 3 straight for the Pistons, who are now 10-5. Take a look, well over 20,000 fans on hand for this one. We go to the second quarter where the Pistons broke it open. Dennis Rodman on the tremendous slam jam there, 2 of his 14 points. Vinny Johnson ends up on this fast break, gets a nice feed from Sally. You can put that kind of shot down for Vinny Johnson, he had 18. But Isaiah Thomas was sensational in the second quarter. 15 of his 17 points, and as Boston turned it over, Isaiah just kept running up and down the floor for baskets. There goes one. Here comes a beautiful move off a screen. He goes right around Larry Bird. Beautiful left-hander off the glass. And we'll show you one more. Chuck Daly said, gee, this guy can play. The Pistons hustled after every loose ball. There's Isaiah down the lane. Pistons win it. Now, they'll host Portland Tuesday, and at halftime of tonight's game, the Pistons held a drawing to name their brand-new Auburn Hills Arena.
The ultimate entertainment city. It's truly a palace. And there you have the name, ladies and gentlemen. That's the name of the arena selected by you. The Palace of Auburn Hills. A name that captures it all.
They didn't exactly drown that out with Shears, a little undercurrent at the Dome tonight, but the Palace will be the new home in Auburn Hills of the Pistons next season. Boys high school basketball teams open their season tonight. It's a palace at Hazlett High School. The Vikings never lose at home. They buried DeWitt 112-65. Take a look at this one. Hazlett went to the quarterfinals last year with a run and gun, and they love to run and gun. DeWitt's Chris Berkemer scores early here for his team in the first quarter as DeWitt hung tough. Now watch Hazlett's Bill Sheldon come down, pop, stop. Beautiful shot right there. Bill Allen for DeWitt back at the other end. DeWitt looked like it was going to hang in there, but Hazlett's got some good veteran players. Tremendous team speed. They got that three-point shot, and Bob Sabler says, boy, no problem for me. He had 22 to lead the way tonight. Now, before this game, Haslett coach Jim Bradley told us he fully expects his team to contend for the Ingham County League Championship once again.
Stockbridge is going to have another really good ball club. The JV team that was that are presently seniors were undefeated as sophomores. Williamson team is going to be improved, and with Portland coming in our league, it's going to be an overall improved league, I think. And I think it will be exciting to watch, and we're going to be able to go up and down the floor. And
are we talking about these 90 to 100-point games again?
I don't think we're going to slow it down too much.
No, and they didn't. All right, let's go over to Holt. A big upset tonight, Holt and Okemos. Holt's Jeremy Baragar on the high feed right there. Holt stunned Okemos tonight, 76-73. Okemos battled valiantly throughout this game, but didn't have enough. Watch little Darren Zwick here for Holt. This kid is not very big, but he can put that left-hander up there. He had 22 points to lead his club tonight. You'll see Okemos' Adam Howell come down and score two of his 26 points, which led all scorers tonight. But at the Holt Middle School tonight, Holt defeats Okemos 76-73. Here's the scoreboard. A lot of non-conference games tonight. Dansville crushed Leslie. It was Quincy over Hillsdale. Jackson edged Adrian. Eastern opens with a big win over Ypsilanti. Lansing Christian over Portland St. Pat's. And Waverly by 9 over Lakewood. Central Montcalm beat Pawama Westphalia. Albion buried Charlotte Saranac over Howard City Tri-County. It was Bellevue nipping Potterville. Grand Ledge over Lansing Catholic on the road. Grand Ledge could be tough. Everett beat Howell tonight. Bath rolled over Battle Creek St. Philip. Jackson County Western easily over East Jackson. And Olivet rolled it up big on Springport. Ionia over Portland tonight. Now in college play, Lansing Community's men over Delta 116-87. Kirk Baker with 29.
Thank you. enough.
Thank you.
record thanks in large measure to the play of a little guy with a big heart named Darren Zwick. He's our TV 10 Athlete of the Week, as Mark Wilson reports.
He isn't Irvin Johnson's height. Heck, he's not even Don Johnson's height. But Darren Zwick leads the Holt Rams with that magic, unseen variable.
I think you need speed, and you just got to have a lot of heart. The key is heart, I think.
Have people told you that all your life,
yeah,
though?
I've always been short, so I've always had to work hard.
Zwick may be last when they take attendance, but first when you talk about basketball here in Holt. Now, because of his size, he's kind of a Spud Webb, Muggsy Bogues-type player. But that's the reason he excites third-year head coach Bruce Larner.
He's intense. He's a very intelligent young man, and he loves the game of basketball, and he's put in more time. I have to drag him out of the gym.
When you have that kind of work ethic, you more than make up for any lack of size.
The kids look up to him, and that's, I mean, when you're 5'8", and they look up to him, but you can talk to some of these guys out here, he's knocked a few of them on their,
Easters.
Yeah, right.
If I score, I score. If I get assist, assist. As long as we win, I'm happy.
And Zwick is happy about being recognized for his 22-point effort in last Friday's upset of Okemos.
Feels pretty good. I don't know, just I played well and shot well, and
that's team, what makes it happen.
Yeah, real team effort.
An effort not unnoticed by Rams hoop supporters. In Holt, I'm Mark Wilson for TV 10 Sports.
Two college.